We're back here at the Leah Cora Center getting you ready for Temple and SMU, and now joining us is the Hall of Fame coach, Larry Brown. Coach, great to see you again. How are you?
Good, good. Good to be back here.
Well, we thank you for coming on, and George is now on your staff. He was on your staff last year, and on the other side, Aaron McKee is now on Fran Dunphy's staff. Both of those guys played on your Sixers teams. How proud of you of those two guys?
I'm proud of all our guys, but, you know, we had Eric before, Eric Snow, and he just got a job with Michael Curry. But, you know, Aaron's an amazing person. I think he's going to be a great coach. It's been a huge asset with Fran already. You know, I love their staff. But when you coach and you get to be around people like George and Aaron and Eric, guys you coach and you see that they're having an impact in this sport, it's the best. I know Coach Chaney would be happy about it as well.
When Allen Iverson retired and had his ceremony at the Wells Fargo Center, a reporter asked him who was one of the teammates that had the best impact on you, and he said Aaron McKee. Why did those two guys have just such great synergy?
I don't know. I mean, you know, Aaron's always been an unbelievable teammate. He's always had tremendous respect in the locker room because of the person he is and his work ethic. But, you know, Allen came to speak to our team, and, you know, he mentioned a lot of guys that he played with, but he said the three that really affected his life the most were Aaron, Eric, and George. They all have similar backgrounds, have similar appreciation for the game.
You know how kind Allen Iverson could be, and when I watched him, he was an exciting basketball player, and there was nothing he couldn't do on the court. To some people, he was an enigma. Describe what it was like to coach the answer.
You know, at the time, I didn't really get it completely. I knew that he had an unbelievable impact on our sport and young people, but I didn't realize the impact he'd have on my life. He's the best athlete I've ever seen, maybe as great a competitor as there ever been. And, you know, sometimes you get frustrated with some of the things he did until he stepped between the lines. You know, you knew he wanted to win, and that was something that really was important to me. But I don't think there'll ever be another one like him.
I know when you were looking for a new job before you took the SMU job, Jay Wright let you come to a bunch of his practices, and also the fans here in Philadelphia, they still love you for the run that you guys went on. I know you came back here last year into this building at the Leah Cora Center, but just to come back to Philadelphia, what does that mean to you?
Well, I mean, not only Jay, I think more than a couple of practices. I was there every day. Or, you know, I'd see Coach Martelli or, you know, somebody in this area. I love Philly for a lot of reasons. I love the people, but, you know, when you love basketball like I do and you look at the programs in the city, high school, college, you have a pro team, this is a great basketball community. So I don't enjoy coming back here coaching against Fran. You know, I have too much respect for him. It's no fun coaching against friends, but I admire him. I admire this program. You know, Coach Chaney has done so much. So from that perspective, it's neat coming back. But this game, I hope it gets over quick.
WHIP Radio, Zach Gelb here with you in Philadelphia, getting you ready for Temple and SMU that will come your way tonight at the Leah Cora Center. Coach, I have to ask you, this was a Temple team last year. They beat you guys, and you guys also beat them once, but they only had 9 wins. This year, they're one of the better teams in the American, already at 12 wins. When you look at the film and the games that you watch them, what's the biggest difference with this team from last year to this year?
Well, they're just better. You know, they got better players. You know, Fran didn't have any depth last year. We played horribly here against them, but, you know, the way they play, they're capable of beating anybody. I can't imagine, you know, I watched the Kansas game. I can't imagine anybody beating Kansas as badly as Temple did. So they're 10 deep. They got a great point guard. They got multiple guys that can score. So they're not only a good American Conference team, they're a good team on a national level.
Will Cummings is such a special guard. I know he's a game-time decision for tonight. How do you prepare for a guy that's a game-time decision, especially a player of his caliber?
I don't worry about anybody we play against. I worry about my team, but I have great respect for him. You know, he was one of the best players in our league last year. And, you know, when you play for Fran, guards are so important. And he's a key to their team, just like Nick Moore would be a key to our team. But we just prepare our guys. You got to take care of the ball against Temple. You got to take great shots. You got to keep them out of transition. They don't beat themselves.
Two more before we let you run. Nick Moore is such a fun player to watch. When he came into the Leocor Center last year, getting to see your practices behind the scenes last year, I had a lot of fun watching him. What makes him so fun to coach?
He's no fun to coach. No.
Explain that a little bit. Yeah, I know. Yeah. You're kidding.
No, he likes to play. He's a great competitor. He can make shots. You know, I think kids that love to play are ones that I enjoy being around. But he's a big part of our team.